Jojo.
Mhm.
Jojo.
Now you gotta stay put. Look more. Cool. Look, there's Mama. Look at Mama. There's Mama. Say Mama. Mama. Are they coming? Oh, okay. You usually stand up. They're coming through the doors. Thank you.
Good afternoon and welcome. Martin and Trent are so glad to have you here on this beautiful October day. As we overlook this beautiful field, we can't help but know that there is a God who loves us and cares for us, a God who has orchestrated life's events that each of us would be here today. For that we are thankful. Let us pray. Dear God, we come to you. Your word says that our steps are ordered by you. Your word says that there is a path that we can walk, and you make the light break on that path. Father, I thank you that you have brought Morgan and Trent together, these two families. And I ask, God, that you would bless this wedding and this marriage. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Who gives this beautiful young bride to this gentleman? You may be seated. Today is a celebration. A celebration of love, of commitment, of friendship, of family, of two families merging to become one. The union of husband and wife are intended by God for their mutual joy, for their help and comfort, help and comfort given to each other in prosperity and in adversity. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. The marriage ceremony has been an important feature across nearly every culture, religion, generation, and society. We have thousands of important moments that happen throughout our lives, but this one is regarded as one so special and so critical that we did not acknowledge it as by inviting others to be a part and take part in this moment. Why this moment? Because these two people have chosen to love each other. Despite all our differences, love is what we share. It's the great unifier, our one universal truth, that no matter who we are, where we come from, what we believe, we know this one thing. Love is what we're doing. One. The Bible is clear in the book of John. Dear friends, let us continue to love one another, for love is from God. Anyone who is born of God knows God, but anyone who does not love does not know God, for God is love. Morgan, I want to thank you for allowing me to be here today. I've known you since you were little, and yes, there was a span of time that I hadn't seen you guys, but when I walked in yesterday, it was like I had never left. It's like I had always been here. And I remember as a little girl how we would see you at church and you would run around, and then when I walked in yesterday, and I thought, wow, you're a young lady. You've all grown up. And I just want to take this time and say thank you so much. Trent, I've talked to you on the phone and we FaceTime, and I want you to know that after I hung up that FaceTime call, I thought, she got her a good man. And I want you to know I believe that. Okay, and then when I watched you yesterday, I thought, yeah, he's a good man. He's going to take care of her. Morgan, will you have Trent to be your husband, to live together with him in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and teach him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Trent, will you have Morgan to be your wife, to live together with her in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful unto her as long as you both shall live? Trent, you will repeat it. I, Trent, take you, Morgan, to to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow. I more than take you, Trent, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow. You both have chosen to wear rings as a reminder of this promise and covenant that you have made. People often say that wedding bands are perfect circles with no beginning and no end, but these rings did have a beginning. A long time ago, deep in the earth, when God formed the universe, and through a series of lucky events, someone dug this metal up. This metal was then liquefied in a furnace at 1,000 degrees, molded, cooled, and painstakingly polished. As a result, something beautiful was made from these raw elements. Love is like that. It comes from humble beginnings, and through a combination of fortunate happenstances and effort, imperfect beings shape it into something extraordinary. It's the process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. As you look at these rings, over the years, I hope you remember, you have created something invaluable. And just as I know you'll protect these rings, I'm confident that you'll protect the commitments that you have made today. Trent, would you take that ring and place it on her hand? Repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. You are the love of my life, and you are my best friend. Morgan, would you place that ring? Repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. You are the love of my life and my best friend. Let us pray. Dear God, I come to you, and I ask God that you would begin and continue to bless this relationship. Lord, I pray for Trent and I pray for Morgan. And God, I ask that you would just minister to them. And as this covenant becomes solidified, Lord, I pray that you would help them learn to protect it, learn to fight for it. When times get hard, help them remember that you are God and that they made a covenant before you to one another. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. To the family and friends who have witnessed this union, will you do all in your power to uphold Morgan and Trent in their marriage? If you will, please respond by saying, "We will."
We will. We will.
It is my honor as a minister of the gospel from the state of Michigan, formerly Texas, and in accordance with the state, I pronounce that you are married. Trent, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce you to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Trent. heart. Woo!